Okay, Mr. Landry's here for English class. And today we have a quiz on pronouns. We're going to do two worksheets. One of them is a quiz for a quiz grade. The other is a bonus, a little bit advanced. So the first thing we'll do is review a little bit. We're going to review worksheet 1X, which we've been working with. 1X looks like what you see here. Worksheet 1X. So, subjective, objective, and possessive pronouns. You will need to identify pronouns today for the quiz. Two quizzes today. One of them for grade, one of them for bonus. Bonus. 5A is for grade, 5B is bonus points. Everybody wants bonus points. We're going to be talking about antecedents for the bonus points. It's a little bit difficult, but if you follow along, you should do well. So here you have worksheet 1X in front of you. Please use worksheet 1X if you have a copy of it. This lists all of the pronouns that you will need to identify. Our expectations for today is you will complete two worksheets. If you complete only 5A, that is fine because that is your quiz grade, but I'd like for you to at least try 5B as we'll do them both in class. Our objective for today, students will be able to identify pronouns and effectively use them in a sentence. Okay, Cottage staff, now is the time. Everyone should have something to write with, and you can always stop or pause the video if necessary. So, something to write with, something to write on, preferably a worksheet. If you don't have worksheet 5A, a piece of loose leaf, pen or a pencil. If you have loose leaf paper, you need to number 1 through 16. 1 through 16. All right, let's see what this quiz is going to look like. You will have 10 minutes. 10 minutes to complete worksheet 5A. And you should see now worksheet 5A quiz on your screen. Worksheet 5A on your screen. Please make sure your name and the date and your cottage name is on your worksheet. 16 questions. Identifying pronouns. We'll read together now. The directions are: a pronoun takes the place of a noun in each sentence. A pronoun can function as the subject of a sentence or as the direct object of an action verb or preposition. Underline the pronoun in each sentence below. So you're underlining the pronoun. Very simple. Keep it simple. Underlining the pronoun. So the pronoun, underline the pronoun. Underline the pronoun in each sentence below. Each one, there are 16. If you do not have a worksheet, pick out a pronoun in each sentence and write it on your paper. 1 through 16, please begin now if you have not already. Let's take about another 5 minutes or so. You should be completing worksheet 5A as a quiz grade, 1 through 16. And if you have a worksheet, you are underlining the pronoun in each sentence. If you do not have a worksheet, you can simply write the pronoun on a piece of loose leaf, 1 through 16. You may pause or stop the video at any time if necessary, if you need more time, or if you need to restart. You may pause or stop the video at any time. All right, we have about another minute or so. And we're wrapping up quiz 5A. You should be completing quiz 5A. Make sure that your name is on your paper, the date and your cottage name. Make sure your name and the date is on your paper. Make sure your name is on your paper. All right, let's review these. Number one, she refuses to talk on the phone. That's a shame. Well, what can we do for her? You can identify a pronoun, that's what we can do. And it should be she. She. Number two, the doorbell rang. But Joe ignored it. The doorbell rang and Joe ignored it is the pronoun. Number three, Tanya called her last week. Tanya called someone with a name, but we'll just call her her. Three is her. Number four, Mary asked him to hurry up. Him is your pronoun. Number five, he doesn't understand English. He is your pronoun. Number six, we went to Montana last summer. We is the pronoun. Number seven, they are conducting a poll. They are conducting a poll. They is your pronoun. Number eight, the man asked them to leave. Them is your pronoun. Number nine, the bus takes too long, he said. Whoever he is your pronoun. Number 10, Tom invited her to the party. Way to go, Tom. Her is your pronoun. Number 11, Rachel asked us about the job. Us is your pronoun. Number 12, we felt bad about the incident. We is your pronoun. Number 13, Ian threw it out the window. All right, well, whatever Ian threw, it is your pronoun. 14, please set it on the table. Don't know if it's what Ian threw out the window, but it is your pronoun. 15, I forgot you were coming. Now here we actually have two for 15. There's two possible choices, and we'll go with I or you, whichever one you want to choose. I forgot you were coming. And 16, Pat never calls me anymore. Ah, that's a shame. Me is your pronoun. Your paper should look something like that if you're completed. If not, you have loose leaf paper, number 16, 1 through 16, and identify the pronouns by writing them down. That concludes today's quiz. You should have completed 5A, identifying pronouns. Make sure your name, the date, and the cottage name is on your worksheet. Quiz 5A. And now we're going to move on to a bonus round. We have a bonus worksheet on antecedents. 5B. You should have a copy of 5B. It looks something like this. Looks something like that. Hopefully you got a copy of 5B. All right, this one's a little bit tougher than all of them. That's why it's a bonus. We'll do the first one together. Antecedents, let's read. 5B, bonus points, pronouns and antecedents. A pronoun, reading at the top of the sheet, a pronoun is a word that takes the place of a noun. For example, Linda loves tomatoes. She eats a lot of them. Them is your pronoun replacing tomatoes. The pronoun she takes the place of Linda. The person pronoun them takes the place of tomatoes. The word that a pronoun takes the place of is called the antecedent. In the example above, you will take note. Linda is the antecedent for she, and tomatoes is the antecedent for them. All right, so our directions, working by yourself. In each sentence, identify the antecedent of the bolded pronoun and write it on the line. So for number one, you need to write in the blank the antecedent for the pronoun it. Let's take 5 minutes now. We have 11 questions, writing 11 antecedents. Please begin now. Working by yourself, this is bonus worksheet number 5B.
Sunshine.
All right, let's take about another 3 minutes, 2-3 minutes, wrapping up the bonus worksheet 5B. We'll share our answers. All right, let's try and wrap up now. 1 through 11, worksheet 5B. If you are using loose leaf paper, make sure your name and date is on it. Number your paper 1 through 11. You just simply need to write the antecedent. What is an antecedent of the bolded pronoun for each sentence? Write it on the line. All right, let us review now. We will review worksheet 5B. Following along, please. 1 through 11, worksheet 5B. Number one, I read the story so I know what happens in it. It should be story. Number two, I asked Marcia to help me, but she said yes. That should be Marcia. That is she. Number three, the leaves on this tree are changing. They are pretty. That should be leaves as your antecedent for they. Number four, my purse is brown, but I carry it when I wear black shoes. That should be purse. Number five, Ellis and Carter don't like tests, but they do well on them. That should be Ellis and Carter. Number six, Jane is sick, so she won't be in school today. Jane is your antecedent for she. Number seven, Kevin got a new job and today is his last day of work. Way to go, Kevin, as the antecedent for number seven. Number eight, I bought a dozen bells and I put them on my dog's collar. Here we have bells. Number nine, I travel on back roads. They are usually clearer. Way to go. Those roads are clear, and that's your antecedent. Number 10, Gina is a jealous friend. She gets upset with me often. Number 10 is Gina, antecedent for she. And the last one, number 11, the red and blue shoes are expensive. I can't afford them. But should be shoes, and there should be here. Are expensive. They are expensive, right? The red and blue shoes are expensive. I can't afford them. The antecedent is shoes. That concludes worksheet 5B. Make sure your name and the date and your cottage is on it if you want bonus points. Antecedents. What does a pronoun modify in a sentence or take the place of? All right, make sure your worksheets 5A, 5B get returned to the PBX by cottage staff. Make sure your name is on them with the date and your cottage name so I can give you credit for that. That concludes our fifth lesson on pronouns. Hopefully you are able to identify pronouns and use them effectively in a sentence. Thank you for your work this week. Hopefully you are doing really well with grammar and punctuation, and I look forward to teaching a little more with reading and writing. Until next time. Have a great day.